show. Well, I think Team Awesome is
awesome. When you're in a state, tune in to Team Awesome.
That's right. Said the music, it says us currently. Hey, in your face. Big ol' hey in
Hi.
Your face. Take it in the face. And we're here to do another thing.
Yep.
This one came out a little bit ago, not too long ago, but this is the internet, so it's irrelevant. This is a sci-fi actioner starring, I'm not sure if it's Dave Franco or James Franco. I think it's Dave Franco, but I'm not sure. No, James Franco. I'm sure it's Dave. No, James. I'm sure of it.
We are positive that a Franco is in this movie.
Yeah, there's a Franco. One of them. It's a Franco-American production. So, no, it's not. Any shits, follow our information below.
Uh-huh.
All the podcast things and the websites and the Twitters and everything, all of it below. Click the link and, all right, you ready to, blah, blah. Are you ready to do the thing?
Yeah.
All right, this is V for Vendetta. And I'm like, just, I don't know why, do you need to know that? Do they need to know that, really?
Yes, or.
Okay, hey.
What's my other name?
V for Vendetta.
What? Vanessa.
Oh, your real one.
Yeah.
That's your real name. All right, in 3, 2.
Fun.
If I'm hard on you, it's because the world is hard. You've seen that.
Okay.
And I just need you to stay out of trouble, okay?
Is this dystopian? Cool. Robots? Aliens? Cool. Oh, yes. Stranger Things and Arrival?
Your brother just got out of prison.
I know I've been away for a long time, but I want to make sure that you know that you're important to me.
I want you to be careful around him.
Welcome home, my man.
There he is. Okay, James.
I know I owe you guys some money. I just want you to know I'm not dodging you.
Oh. Ooh.
Uh-oh.
Let him go.
Oh, man.
Uh-oh.
Oh, boy. Yeah, you better be careful with that. That's...
What the hell is that?
I found it.
Somebody's got to be looking for this thing.
Oh, whoa.
That thing your brother has in
there? Are they robots or are they aliens? Robot aliens?
Can't do that.
Find them. He's here somewhere.
Dangerous people are coming after us.
I know I'm not a good guy, but it's been pretty incredible to be brothers for the first time.
Whatever you've gotten him into, he's gonna figure it out eventually. I hope you're ready for that.
What?
They're coming, man. Go!
I can't believe this whole time you haven't told me this. Go, go!
Whoa.
Get away from my brother.
Yikes.
Maybe keep that thing on the first mode, yeah?
What the hell?
No idea. I have no idea what's going on. Coming soon. So, we don't know what it is. We don't know what's going on, but it's coming soon.
Well, I kind of got the gist of it. It's one of those, I messed up and owe bad people money, and now they're coming after me and everyone I love, but oh, alien robots.
What? Could you? Okay, try that again, but this time do it in a way that I can understand it.
It's one of those movies about someone who messes up and owes bad people money, and then they're going to come after them and everyone they love, but they're also robot aliens.
Oh, okay. So instead of it being like the mafia.
Yeah.
Like, right. I see what you're saying. So like you're saying this is almost, it's almost tropey if not for the robot aliens.
Yeah.
The robe aliens. The Tron aliens? What would you call them? I don't know, but the tech looks cool. I don't know if it's earthly or unearthly. I don't know if this is a near future. I mean, it seems like there's sort of like, it's one of those movies where it's sci-fi, but it's got like a B plot going on. The
yeah.
A plot is... I think the A plot's always like the overall plot that's going on,
mm-hmm.
and then the B plot is the background thing.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I think with this film with Kin, it depends. Is the A plot going to be the family stuff? or is that the B plot? Now, I know they're both going to be happening simultaneously. One is going, is correlating. Not, one doesn't correlate with the other necessarily, but like, what's going to be the more forward story? The story of brothers or the alien story? If the human story, see, this is where I'm saying, like sci-fi movies like this, I love it. Because like, it's kind of real world based, but then they bring the fantasy element in. So it's like, if the sci-fi is heavily pushed, it could be more about the sci-fi, and I'm fine with that. But if the brother story is pushed, this could be a clever way of getting like a really heart-wrenching story in amongst all the sci-fi action superhero stuff. Because hey, yeah, there's aliens and there's like alien tech and guns, but really it's about the heart. It's really about the story and about the people at the center of it and the characters at the center. Yeah, that's all fun stuff, but that's just to get you in. I hope that's the case. I don't know yet because I haven't seen it, so I don't know. I could be talking out of my butt. I usually am. What's the scoop?
I think that an A-B plot movie, generally, the more prominent plot is used to evolve the secondary plot. So I think in this situation, the secondary plot might be the family, just because their relationship is going to evolve based on how the series, the events unfold.
That's very true. Yeah, you're absolutely right about that. But again, it could go the other way. Who knows? I mean, we'll see how this plays out. But I applaud them for being different and taking risks with science fiction and the genre. It doesn't have to be like one way or the other. It can be whatever you want. It just, you know, do we need the robo aliens in this? I mean, it could be the mafia. It could be zombies. You know, it could be vampires. It just happens to be robot aliens or whatever. Fine. But as long as the story is there and as long as the characters are there, you know, because if it's about family, then that's what we need. Man, I hate to get all sentimental about stuff. And then, of course, the obligatory James Franco. He's in almost everything now. You can't move forward with it. Do you think this is a larger part, or do you think he shot for a day and they like put it in the trailer? Or do you think he's in it more?
No, because it seems like he's like the head of the group that the guy owes money to.
That's true.
Is the impression that I got.
He could still be in it very sparingly. Like, that's all we see of him.
Yeah, if the alien robots is going to be the more prominent plot point.
Possibly. But then again, it's like, who knows? Regardless, and of course, James Franco. I have this weird thing. Anytime I see James Franco or Dave Franco in a movie, I laugh a little. And it's not because it's not because I think they're bad or I think it's a wrong idea, but because I have such a familiar frame of reference with James Franco and Dave Franco from comedies that when I see them in other movies, because like I got to know them through comedies, when I see them in other films, I kind of instantly laugh about it. I'm kind of like, oh yeah, it's kind of funny because they remind me of all the funny stuff they did. But that's only that's like a novelty. That's a novelty thing, really. You move beyond that after a while, which is okay. Like when we were watching
Ghost movie, not a
vampire. No, Colin Farrell.
Fright Night. I thought you were talking. You have to specify which Franco.
Yeah, Dave. Sorry.
Okay,
Dave
so
Franco. Yeah, you're right.
Fright
My
Night.
Fault.
Yeah,
My
when
fault.
We're
gotta,
watching Fright Night.
I gotta get the I gotta get the Francos because it's easy to mix them up.
Yeah.
If you're not careful. Dave Franco was in Fright Night, and I laughed very hard when I saw him in it. And I'm like, is he turned into a vampire? Come on, that'd be great. And then I moved beyond it after the novelty wore off. And then I didn't want him to die. This is same kind of thing. I think it's just my own personal issue, so never mind.
No, I have the exact same reaction.
Oh, good.
Except mine isn't because of comedies necessarily. The reason I giggle when I see James Franco is because of Spring Breakers.
Oh, Alien.
Alien.
Yo, my name's Alien. Oh my God, I bet it is.
Spring Break forever.
It's the greatest. He should have won an Oscar for that. He should have won an Emmy for that. Emmy? Yeah, why not?
So now just because of that character, whenever I see him, I just think of him in that. And
well, okay. Well, all right. So Ken, since it's robot aliens and we've got Alien in the movie, out of five aliens, what do you give Ken trailer one?
I'm going to give it a 4 for two reasons. One, I didn't get enough. Like, it was a long trailer, but I need to know more.
I hear you.
And two, I wasn't clear on whether it's... This could be a Netflix movie.
Yeah, that's true. It could be.
So I don't know whether it's Netflix or whether it is coming out in theaters, which always influences my rating because I'm lazy and I don't want to leave my house. So.
Well, at some point, all movies end up on Netflix, I think, or will. It's like HBO. It's the HBO rule. It used to be the HBO rule back in the day. It was the HBO rule. Eventually, all movies will be on HBO or Showtime. Now it's the Netflix rule or the Amazon instant rule. Eventually, everything will be on Netflix at some point,
yeah,
or TV or whatever. But if it's if it premieres there, I don't think it premieres there. But I'm looking forward to the premiere of this. It says mm-hmm. coming soon. I want a release date immediately.
Yes.
Immediately.
Yes.
I think that's French. Immediately. Mm,
that was something.
It's something. Might be Creole. It's always
Did you
a
say
mix.
Creole.
Creole is always a mix.
Creole.
Creole.
Oh boy.
Creole. That's gonna do it. Thanks. Our information is below. Thanks.
Bye.
Goodbye. Creole. 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 This has been Team Awesome. Team Awesome. Awesome experience. Well, you know we're doing just so right. Awesome. Team Awesome Inc. Wink, wink. Shut up. Yeah.